One of the coolest things about cloud platforms like Azure is just how fast and easy you can spin up new resources. No need to rack, stack, and cable stuff anymore. Heck, you don't even have to set up the software if you don't want to. It can become way too easy to cause environment and configuration drift if you aren't careful. Today, I'm going to show you the fundamentals on how to build and deploy infrastructure as code in Azure through ARM templates so that this sort of drift won't happen to you. Dana up here. Welcome to the channel that helps aspiring Azure administrators like you and me to know ops and, well, master the Microsoft cloud. I'm glad you're here. If you haven't yet, smash the subscribe button so you can be notified when I release new videos each week. So the world of infrastructure as code is here. In Azure, this can be accomplished using Azure Resource Manager with something called ARM templates. An ARM template is nothing more than declarative code that describes Azure resources and allows you to instruct the Azure Resource Manager backplane in how to deploy it. It's basically a JSON file that describes everything. It can be as simple or as complex as you want it, allowing you to deploy virtually anything and everything in short order. You use ARM templates all the time, if you know it or not. Even when you're deploying something through the portal that you've selected from the marketplace, behind the scenes, ARM gets the instructions on what to do through these templates. In fact, if you look closely just before you create a resource, there's a link to download a template for automation. Click it sometime and check it out. That's an ARM template. There are other ways to see an ARM template. One of my favorite ways is to go to the existing resource groups and click on the Export Template blade. That will load up a screen where Azure will generate an ARM template from all of your existing resources within that resource group. It even sets up the parameters for you so that if you ever wanted to deploy the exact same environment in another resource group, subscription, or tenant, you can. Those parameters are used to prompt you during deployment on what you want the values to be. When you're in the portal, that'll show up in text fields and dropdowns that you see in the UI. If you use the Azure CLI, those are the params that you get prompted for. Of course, you can use the export template blade on individual resources in the same way. So it becomes very easy to generate ARM templates for individual resources or entire deployments if you like. One tip though, when exporting a template from existing resources, there's a bunch of additional noise that's created with the templates that relates specifically to that deployment. These are things that you'll want to strip out if you ever wish to reuse the template elsewhere. There are several online resources that you can walk through that will show you how to do that if you ever need to. But let me show you an even better way to get clean ARM templates for use for infrastructure as code in Azure. Head on over to azure.microsoft.com/resources/templates. This is the Azure Quick Start Template Gallery. It's a great site where you can deploy Azure resources through the Azure Resource Manager with community contributed templates to get more done. You can deploy, learn, fork, and even contribute back to GitHub everything you need for infrastructure as code. Check it out. There are literally hundreds upon hundreds of ARM templates already built for you to deploy everything from simple VMs all the way to complex deployments with multiple servers, databases, and all the networking configuration to make everything talk together in a safe manner. What I like is that the gallery includes a button to deploy these templates straight to Azure. You're obviously responsible for knowing what the templates are doing, and you will need to provide any values for the parameters required. But it's a quick way to get new infrastructure up and running in a consistent manner in just a matter of minutes. Beside the button to deploy to Azure is another button that gives you the option to look at the template in GitHub. I encourage you to check out a few templates that interest you so that you can get comfortable with the structure and syntax of an ARM template before you start deploying it. To help you understand how these templates work, why don't we jump into a session and I'll walk you through all the basics on how you can build your first template from scratch. It's the best way to learn this in Azure, and I'll show you a few tools and tips to make this much easier on you. So let's start from the very basics. An ARM template is just a text file. It's written in a format called JSON, which is a lightweight format for storing and transporting data. It stands for JavaScript Object Notation, but don't worry, it's not some evil dark art left only for developers. More importantly, while it's based on JSON, an ARM template is more than that. Its schema allows an ARM template to do additional things like host comments that JSON just can't do. That's helpful when we write our infrastructure as code, as we can document what we're doing right in the template. So let's write our first template. I'm going to use Visual Studio Code to do this, which is a free editor that Microsoft makes available on many different platforms like Windows, Mac, and Linux. Why I like VS Code is that it's a powerful framework that allows you to install extensions that can help you build and work with pretty much anything. In our case, I've installed the Azure Resource Manager Tools extension, which is going to really help us here shortly. I'll leave a link to all this in the show notes so that you can download it later if you haven't already. To get started though, what I'm going to do is make my first file. So let's say we want to deploy a storage account. We have it a .json extension, and we can see on the bottom right that VS Code is saying, hey, the language here is JSON that we're going to be using as the language mode. But with that ARM toolkit extension, it can detect things and use things like snippets to help with IntelliSense to really help guide us along the process of building an ARM template. So as an example, if I type ARM, it automatically will create a skeleton for us if I just hit enter. And what you can see from this is an ability to build off of the 2015 schema, but we also got prompted and said, hey, do you want to use a newer schema? And I'm going to say, yes, I want to use the latest. And that's going to convert it to the 2019 format, which has a whole bunch of new pieces in the templating that we can take advantage of, like that leaving comments and case sensitivity doesn't matter as much. And there's like just a whole bunch of things to make our life a lot easier. So that scaffolding though is pretty nice. And by approving it, make sure you improve it to change it from the 2015 schema to 2019. Once we've done that though, let's go and build our first resource. So if you know anything about how JSON works, you see things like square brackets like this that typically usually means an array. Doesn't have to, but that's what it usually means. So in our case here, we're gonna have the ability to put in multiple resources. We're just gonna start by adding one resource, but you could add as many as you want to. And it works by the order of precedence, by what's at the top. That gets deployed first, then it's what's next and what's next. So that way, if you have dependencies, you can make sure that those get deployed first. In our case though, what we want to do is we said we want to do a storage account. So if I put a dash and then hit S for storage, I can then select that and it automatically scaffolds out the configuration for a resource. You need a name and a type, any tags that might be there, such as display name and the properties that might relate to what we're building out. And this in itself is actually all that's needed to create an ARM template. If I literally just save this, I have everything I need to get going. So if I wanted to build out and deploy this, I can easily do this. Way we can do this is that if you happen to have the Azure CLI as an example, which I have down here in the terminal, I can just check, make sure I'm logged in, and I am. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to actually go and deploy this out. The way to do that is you type AZ group deployment create. I have a group called KnowOps. And we have this template file called deploy storage. And what we can see here is the deployment failed because that storage account one has already been taken. Okay, well, it means someone already has that name. So maybe we want to change that. While we're going to change it, the easiest way to do that would be to maybe change it into a variable and change those values. So over here under the variable section, I can create a new variable. In this case, maybe I'll call it name. And I'll call it Dana Store. And then what I could do is replace the actual hard-coded value I have here with a call to the variables. Now to do this, there's actually a need to put square brackets inside of quotes so it knows to look up the variables, and then I can look up the variable like the name. So you can see right there. And what this will now do is it'll take whatever that variable is, and let's try running it again. And there we go. Now we have this storage account deployed. Now here's a problem. In that case of having that variable, if I was to run this again, it's gonna fail just like the first time because there's already a storage account with the name Dana Store. So maybe a better way to do this, it would be not to use a variable, but instead to make it a parameter so that you can prompt for the name and change it as you need to. So the best way that we can probably do that is if we were to think about, you know, how we want to change it, we could go into the parameters value that's up here and we could create a new parameter. So we're going to move that variable, which we call name, and we'll move it up into here. And you can notice as I'm typing in, it's auto-completing and telling me the value type is a required value. And I need to know that. And it happens to be a type of a string. And there'll be some metadata. And by putting something like a metadata of description, whenever we get prompted, we can see this. So if we're doing this in the portal as an example, it'll create a text field and it'll say, enter the name of your storage account, which is kind of what we want there. Then of course we'll have to get rid of this variable because can't have the duplicate. And then of course that means that this is broken because it's not a variable anymore. It's a parameter. And there you go. Now we have this parameters set up. Now, before we deploy this, one of the things we might want to do since we've making so many changes is to validate that the template is working good. And we can do that by typing az group deployment validate. And you'll see one of the first things it's doing is it's prompting me now because I set up a parameter. And you'll see that it succeeded. Now it didn't actually deploy it because I just asked to validate it. But now I can use that exact same command, change it to a create. And now it's going to ask us. And we'll do another deployment. And if we now look we can see we now have two storage accounts. So we did the first one where everything was hard-coded. The second one we used by passing in a parameter. The third way we can do it is by using a parameters file. And that gets useful because on some larger templates, there could be literally dozens of parameters and you're not gonna wanna try to have to hit enter all those times, especially if you're gonna redeploying all the time. You could script this out using, you know, DevOps pipelines or through parameter files that are auto-generated to deploy the infrastructure as you need to. So the way we do this is we create a parameters file. So we'll create a new file here. We'll call this one deploy storage.params.json. Again, this starts off as a JSON file, but if I type arm p for a parameter skeleton, boom, automatically creates that skeleton file. And then I can just go in and put in the values that I want for the parameters. So in my case here, we had a parameter called name. And it's gonna have a value of, well, we did two, so why don't we call this one Dana Store 3. And then we just have one other parameter that we pass into the create, which is minus minus parameters.
and then you would include that parameters file. And then let's do another deployment. And there you have it. So if we take another look, we now have three storage accounts set up and deployed automatically using ARM templates. And it took no time at all. Now we can know that we can deploy this consistently every single time. Now we're just using a single simple storage account here, but you could do this and deploy this with multiple servers and storage accounts and key vaults and web apps and have it all working through a single template and parameter file, which you can then manage in your GitHub repos or your Azure repos and be able to consistently deploy infrastructure as code the same way every single time that you want to do it.
With ARM templates, infrastructure as code isn't that hard in Azure. Using it can save you tons of time and help prevent the unwanted environment and configuration drift that can happen in the cloud so easily. I hope I've been able to show you the basics of ARM templates in a way that will get you to start using them. Not only can you use them in the Azure CLI or in the portal like I've shown today, you can use them in things like your DevOps pipelines to automate all this. What do you think? Was this helpful? Let me know by hitting the like button. And if you haven't yet, smash the subscribe button so that you can be notified as I publish new content each week. Until then, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next episode.